this episode, this happens, this happens. Now, he had bullet points. This happens, and in this scene, da-da-da, and then we're off and running, and we're recording, and we're previewing each line in Japanese. So I know, it's like, okay, here's my script, here's the footage, all right, cool, and then we try to make it match the lip sync. Yeah?
Just like a follow-up. I know a lot of the time I hear from other voice actors that, like, they'll hear something and they get upset with, like, the take that was used. How often do you think that applies to you? Do you usually think it's, like, the best take gets used, or do you sometimes feel like you wish it were a different one? Or?
Well, I think because people have their own opinions. Yeah, there's times where I think, oh, that take was totally right, and they use another one that's bigger or more over the top. I like to say anime. More anime, more exaggerated. More like, what? It's like, but I always like it when sometimes, it doesn't happen often enough, but when the directors say, we want more grounded, more cinematic, more real. And, you know, once in a while we'll get to do that. And sometimes it sounds bigger in the Japanese, but they'll say, no, pull back. Like, Gurren Lagann, said, the animation's big, but we're going to keep this just complex. Wants us to play it more real.
That was stupid. That was stupid of them to make you tone down Kamina, in my opinion, Kyle.
Sorry.
Did you go through any process when it came to voicing Danganronpa characters, or have you gone through any process in voicing any video game at all?
Go through what now?
Like a certain process.
A process. Well, the process is the same on all games, copy and paste. It is, we record with the games, instead of matching lip sync for the most part, you're matching the timing of the Japanese audio, because that's what's being used to animate the footage. Nowadays, depending on the budget of the game, they say, oh yeah, so the footage you're seeing, that's a rough cut of what the Japanese is gonna look like, but focus on the timing because they're gonna reanimate the mouths. That's like, that's cool, whenever they do that. Of course, you can't do that with live action. Like tons of shows from Europe and Asia get licensed on Netflix, and you'll end up hearing a lot of anime voice actors on them. They don't credit them, but we end up dubbing them a lot of live action stuff. And the subtleties of the human mouth, it's not like anime is just open and closed, right? Very few mouth shapes, but everything's subtle with the human mouth. So they have to be scripted pretty particular. You know, we're doing all sorts of pretty granular details. Like if someone goes, you know, clicks their mouth when they open, we have to. And we don't do that in anime. But when they're like, you know, is it a open mouth? Is it closed mouth? Is it clenched teeth? And sometimes they'll ask for that in a video game. So they say, we want this. Okay, you're getting hit. You're getting punched. And now you're doing the hitting, and you're doing the punching. It's like, oh, okay. Let me go back here and I'll put it on.
Okay. You said you record a lot at home now, or whatever. You don't have to go anywhere. Did they set you up, like you your own personal studio in your home?
Or no.
Don't say conspiracy. Don't say conspiracy. Don't say conspiracy.
There is one studio in Los Angeles that they make mobile recording kits. They deliver it to the actor's place. And the reason they do that is not just because maybe the actor doesn't have the equipment. All the actors have the equipment because that's just kind of a work requirement. But the reason they do these mobile recording kits is because they want to have a consistent sound. You know how there's different mics? Everyone sounds a little bit different on different mics, recording in different environments. The mixers and the audio mixers have that task, and this is daunting. Workload for the engineers through the pandemic to sit there and mix everything, and they've been doing a stellar job of all this anime you've watched in the past few years has been recorded from Texas, California, New York, all over the place, but it sounds consistent. They're able to, you know, do some audio magic with the recording program Pro Tools, different audio filters, just like there's filters for Instagram. Pictures look like they're from the 60s or super, super crisp.
project that you worked on, or like a couple of them?
The favorite project, one that just meant so much to me, is Wreck-It Ralph, even though it's 10 seconds. It's like, hey, I got to be on a Disney movie, man. That's awesome. And not a movie star. So thank you, Disney, for not casting some big celebrity as Reed. That meant a lot. And getting to start a career on such a big show as Dragon Ball, and having it mean so much to different generations, and even now, we got this new movie coming out. Chapter 4 yet, by the way, so don't ask. Do you have any knowledge? Like, no, I truly don't. And if I did, I still can't talk about it. You'll know in a few weeks, though, if it comes out in Japan, then it comes out here later this summer, early fall. I don't know the release date yet, but I'm sure you'll hear it in English. Yeah. Did I get you on?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
We know that you're predominantly a voice actor, but have you done anything that was live action based in the past?
Yeah, like it's been over a decade, but when I moved to LA, it's like, we gotta get some income going. A lot of people juggle multiple jobs, day jobs and all that stuff. I was doing audio production work behind the scenes, not for anime, but for like internet talk shows and things. And another thing that a lot of people do, whether they're actors or not, they'll end up signing up with a company called Central Casting. And Central Casting is responsible for casting actors in the backgrounds of movies and TV shows. So I've done that. I got to be an extra, you don't see it, in the third Pirates of the Caribbean movie, in the opening scene. They dressed me as a pirate. They made my teeth look nasty.
So you got hung on the gallows?
I got hung on the gallows, except not literally. They didn't put a rope around my neck. They showed other people on camera. Those actors are called featured extras. Featured meaning they get like a shot where they're the main thing in the shot. And you get a bump in pay for that. And if they speak, you get a bump in pay for that. So usually, when you see extras and crowd scenes and all that, that's all dubbed. That's not the people on the set doing that. They have them do that just to make it feel natural and all that, but they don't want to have to pay all the extra money. So instead, they pay what's called a loop group, a bunch of voice actors who are in the room to do that, and they're paid one session fee, you know, maybe like $800 or something, and they probably most of the time don't get credited, to sound like they're in the background. Even the zombies in Walking Dead and all that, all the people that are playing zombies when they were filming in Atlanta.
Were you one of them?
No, I'm not. That's a hot spot, though. It's like the new Hollywood, because Marvel shoots a lot of their stuff there. And Walking Dead, you know.
And of course, don't get me started on the Kirk Cameron films.
Did not get to do the R.I. They pay voice actors in L.A. to do that. And I wish I got to do that, because that'd be fun. I'm a zombie, or I'm a stormtrooper, got killed because I can't shoot. I'd love to do that. It's like, that sounds like the ultimate. It's like, I just want to be a guy who has like 1 second in some major franchise, and you look back and it's like, that's me!
So essentially, you like just being the background character all the time.
Well, all actors want to be the main role.
But I mean, I don't really get that aura with you. You mostly end up getting the background role, and you don't seem to mind. You're okay with playing second fiddle.
I'm okay with working. You want to work. And sometimes, when it comes to anime, you know, I'm making the same amount as someone else who talks more, or is a more featured role. So there's that. There's some equality, I guess. And then there's other inequality, but it's weird. Like, I've been a background soldier screaming on Titanfall. You hardly hear me in the game. But I was in that booth for 12 hours, 3-4 hour sessions. Every week. And it was nothing but screaming at the top of my lungs. I was shredding my vocal cords. And then the game comes out. It's like, oh, there I am. And then 10 minutes later, oh, there I am. not a featured thing, not a playable character, just background battlefield chatter. All that. It's like, wow, they paid a lot of money to hardly use me.
Well, you understood my point, though, right, Kyle?
Yeah, I am happy to work. Of course, perfect world, I would get to be Batman or something, but...
I'm just saying that in terms of the voice acting world, you're basically the Luigi to everyone else being Mario in one way or another.
I'm happy because usually the side characters are the fan favorites.
Exactly.
People tell me, he was my favorite!